Hello and welcome to the big picture. Just a couple of days back, the Planning Commission member, Mr. Mihir Shah, gave a report to the Rural Development Minister, Mr. Jairam Ramesh. The report is about how the MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, will take shape from April 1st onwards. There are a lot of changes which are being made to improve the scheme, but there are also complaints coming from some quarters from agriculturists who have always been complaining that the NREGA has been a problem as far as agriculturists are concerned. So we are today looking at this whole issue, what MGNREGA 2 is about, and also whether this National Rural Employment Guarantee Act has been a threat to the agriculture in India. To discuss this with me is Mr. Hanan Mulla, Central Council member of the All India Kisan Sabha, Dr. Santosh Mehrotra, Director General, Institute of Applied Manpower Research, and on the phone lines will be Mr. Nikhil Day of the Mazdoor Kisan Shakti Sangathan from Bangalore, and also Mr. P. Changal Reddy, Secretary General of the Consortium of Indian Farmers Association. Welcome to all of you. Now, first, let me go to Mr. Hanan Mulla. Mr. Mulla, this new NREGA, which is going to come into effect from April 1st, you think there is an improvement on the previous one?
Yes, I think there are improvements, because when this law was made, I had played a big role.
Yes.
About 50% of the act.
You were a member of parliament from the Lok Sabha, and you are also a
standing committee member. Lots of work we did.
Yes.
And the bill was improved a lot. Initially, it was very diluted form.
Yes.
But later on, about 66th amendment we got after consultation of hundreds of people and representative of the all organization. And then we improved it, and finally this shape took place. But still there are some deficiencies.
Yes.
Actually, one was on the wage question, variations of wages.
Yes.
Then was the schedule of work. There is a problem. Mm. Then very limited work was there, and because India is vast country and diversity are there. Mm. Same type of work is not available in everywhere.
Right.
So where river is more, you cannot implement those program in Dagestan,
right,
or in this desert. So all this stuff, anomalies are there, and we also say then these demands are raised.
Right.
But after a lot of discussion, that bill was passed. And then they said it will be improved upon later on.
Right.
Then state governments also, they suggested something. They should have some liberty to select work. All these things were there.
So there have been a lot of, there was a lot of discussion. And finally, it took a shape. Now it's been nearly 6 years since this has been implemented. Let me go to Nikhil. Nikhil, NREGA 2, one of the most important aspects of it is that, work on private lands belonging to small and marginal farmers, will be included in the NREGA. You think this is a good idea?
That's already there, actually, Girish.
Yes.
But you can do work on SCST and
yes,
PPL families.
Right.
And it is of great benefit to many people.
Yes.
The NREGA won the first. Many questions were raised by many people who had doubts about it, whether it would run at all or work at all.
Right.
I think it's been clear that it has had a fundamental effect on the very poor workers in rural areas, the landless, and
right,
even those who have very poor quality land.
Yes.
But there have been certainly very, very large areas where it has not been implemented well enough.
Yes.
And even in areas where it is implemented, there is a need now for improvement. So these various new suggestions which have come in this, what is being called NREGA 2.0,
yes,
is actually an improvement on many of the things that is there. It's not a departure from, it's an addition to, and it's a strengthening of some of those provisions.
Right.
The land, the work on private land of people who have degraded land,
yes,
I think that's very important to increase our agricultural productivity.
Productive, yes.
And it is work that NREGA actually focuses on the small, on the marginalized And in many ways, its solutions are that small solutions are much better.
One of the nickel, one of the problems which was being discussed all these last few years has been that because of the NREGA, the farm labor's rates have gone up. Agriculturists are not able to afford them, and especially the small and marginal farmers are not able to afford them. So this provision which has been made is going to help at least the small and marginal farmers, right?
Yeah, it will help the small and marginal farmers because their land improvements can be made on their land, land development can take place.
Yes.
And I think that this sort of tension that is being talked about between the landless labor and the small farmers or medium farmers.
Right.
I think actually that has been exaggerated by the large farmers.
Right.
And even the large farmers, the problems in the agricultural sector need to be dealt with separately, not by saying that the landless laborer who may be earning a little bit more because of NREGA, they are to blame for agriculture reducing. Finally, if we want a proper, sustainable agricultural sector,
right,
we will have to make sure that those who work in that sector get enough.
Absolutely.
And we will have to make sure that sector right, also gets enough.
Right, right. Nikhil, just stay on. Let me go to Mr. Changal Reddy. Mr. Changal Reddy, who is the Secretary General of the Consortium of Indian Farmers Associations. Mr. Reddy, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Mr. Reddy, now you heard what the two guests here have said. You think that NREGA, NREGA, has been helpful in increasing the agricultural productivity?
To be honest with you, this NREGA has messed up farmers' lives thoroughly. Because previous plans, this has been thrust upon farmers by Government of India Planning Commission and all sorts of people sitting in Delhi who doesn't understand the ground reality. Now, first let me tell you, see, agriculture problems are there only mainly in rain-fed conditions.
Right.
It's not a question of large, small or anybody. You see, in Punjab or Andhra where there is a water facility, it is whether it is 1 acre or 10 acres, the problems are uniform.
Right.
It's the question of credit, availability of labor, and then cost, pricing, export policies, which quality seeds, inputs. You see, that is uniform for everybody.
Right.
Now, the main problem originally, if I remember, this was brought up by Sonia Gandhi when she visited Bundelkhand. She had a brainwave, and then she wanted some sort of assistance for the rain-fed areas, which was appreciable.
Right.
But somehow down the line, they forgot, and then they made it into a political issue so that it became a vote-catching device, a populistic scheme.
Right, Mr. Reddy.
Where is the question?
No, Mr.
I would ask a simple question. Where is the question of farmers not labor, agriculture labor, or farmers not having work? In Punjab, Haryana, Western UP, Coastal Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, wherever projects where there is a 30% area in the whole country where assured water is there, where there is no question of the labor or small farmers not having work. You have work all the time.
Right. Mr. Reddy, I think you have made your point. Please stay on. I'll come back to you. Let me go to Dr. Mehrotra. You heard all the arguments. Mr. Reddy is a very strong argument. He thinks that NREGA itself is a ill-conceived, misconceived idea. Do you think NREGA has made a major change as far as the labor? You do a lot of work on labor. You think it has made any serious change in this country?
It has served as a safety net for agricultural labor, for small and marginal farmers in lean periods, no question about it. On that, the evidence is absolutely overwhelming that it has served as a safety net. It has raised wages, not just under NREGA, but for rural market wages.
It has had a spin-off.
Spillover effect on rural market wages,
right,
which has in turn had an effect on urban wages, because
right,
urban wages for unskilled workers have also been rising. So there is
right,
a spillover effect of NREGA, not just in rural, but in urban wages, urban
areas.
No question about that. But the other question is the following. There were two objectives of NREGA.
Right.
One was to provide a safety net to the poor in rural areas. The other was to raise agricultural productivity
right,
by sort of improving soil, land, water conservation. Now, this second objective, whether it has been realized or not, is almost impossible to answer definitively one way or the other.
Because maybe it's too short a time for.
No, that's not true. It's not too short a time at all. It is already over six years since it was implemented, and therefore, had we got a baseline for what productivity was 6 years ago, and now if we did a study, we would know. But we don't know, and it's next to impossible to actually determine. Which is one of the reasons why questions are being raised. Because if incomes rise, as they have risen in rural areas, and the proportion of the population below the poverty line falls, then those income rises must not be offset by a price rise of food grains. But prices have been rising of food grains. So there's a real issue about the productivity of agriculture.
Whether these are linked. We will discuss this further. We need to go to a short break now. We'll come back and discuss all the issues raised by Dr. Mehrotra and also Mr. Reddy and my other two panelists. Please keep watching. I'll be back soon.
What is the state of Tamils in Sri Lanka today?
When Sri Lanka sneezes, Tamil Nadu catches a cold. The demilitarization is an aspect which the government must address very seriously.
Minister of Justice, Sri Lanka, only on Raj Sabha TV.
Welcome back. We are discussing the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, the new guidelines for that, and we are asking the question whether NREGA has been a threat to the agricultural activities in this country. Let me go to Nikhil. Nikhil, you heard what Santosh Mehrotra was talking about. You think in the last 6 years, from your own experiences at the grassroots level, has there been a visible increase in agricultural productivity?
NREGA certainly is targeted to try and increase agricultural productivity, but as Santosh said, this has been a problem of the academic community, that they have not really done proper research of what was the baseline situation,
right,
and what is the situation after NREGA works have been carried out.
He also made
that
point.
What we have is anecdotal evidence everywhere,
yes,
and the large assertions, particularly from the English media, that NREGA work has been useless. We have seen in cases, even where it is not well implemented, many of those water harvesting structures, the wells that have been built, the land development that has taken place,
right,
has helped at least those farmers and those people who benefit from that. Even the roads have connected Dalit bastis and provided some kind of rural infrastructure.
Right.
So the study to show whether it is good or not good, how good or how bad or how poor it has been, those studies have not really taken place. So we cannot speak on a scientific basis.
Right.
But there is no doubt that those works, when you go, wherever we go and we travel widely in the country, people say there is a utility to those works.
Okay.
So the question of the,
The new guidelines also has expanded the number of works, the kind of works which can be taken up.
Yeah, which
under
was very necessary. You see, the Act in its earlier schedule had just a limited number of works with the idea that it should be expanded.
Right.
Now, the new guidelines said how it can be expanded while keeping the objectives of the Act in mind.
Right.
And the structure into place. So hopefully appropriate to different parts of the country. We will have different kinds of activities which will again help the fisher communities, people living in the hills.
Right, right.
Those are areas that were challenges. I think things like disabled people also.
It's very interesting that disabled people and people above the age of 65, there are provisions for all of them.
Right, but 65 can't really work, but disabled people can do a lot of very useful work.
Yes, yes.
These are things that we need to bring in.
And these guidelines very specifically talks about what kind of work these handicapped people, the disabled people can do. Anyway, let me go to Mr. Chengal Reddy. Mr. Reddy, the question of agricultural productivity. You people have been talking about how the productivity has come down. Do you think that it has come down because of the NREGA?
Absolutely. See, the whole, you see, the, look, the whole scheme has messed up in two ways.
Yes.
First of all, it was more a Congress party scheme to just to make it populistic. What you ask this gentleman to tell me how much assets have been built for the money spent in the last lakhs of crores. We saw this, what is the assets built
Mr. Reddy,
next to nothing.
No, Mr. Reddy, 150,000 crores has been the expenditure on NREGA in the last 6 years.
That's what I'm telling you. This is exactly what I'm telling you. You see, when our production cost is 1,400 rupees, government fixes 1,100 rupees MSP, and they are not interested to give any bonus to farmers, even the production cost. But simply these populistic schemes come, and then you waste a lakh and 50,000 crores simply because they get you votes in the elections. Now, I am asking for two. No, please, you hear me.
Please tell me.
No, two fundamental questions. Tell me, how is this particular scheme has helped the productivity? Our earlier labor cost was 35%. Today, it has gone to 65%. How, in which manner? And it was never linked to any productivity activity so far. In regard to so-called asset building in the villages, we accept probably for Gujarat and few parts where the state took initiative and advantage of the scheme. Rest of the country, it is nothing but a corruption between officers, politicians, and others.
Okay.
See, even today, I am telling you, finally, please hear me one second. Let me tell you one thing.
Yeah.
The scheme purpose should be slightly different. It should be, ultimately linking with farmers, this has to be decided by the panchayat at the Gram Sabha. Not somebody sitting in planning commission or PMO or somewhere else. See, what we expect government to do is, when you give some resources, allow the local bodies, panchayats, gram sabhas, to decide what to do with these schemes.
Absolutely, Mr. Reddy. In fact, if you see the guidelines, it will be the gram sabhas which will decide the very strict time schedules which have been given for gram sabhas. I'll come back to you, Mr. Reddy. Let me take Mr. Hanan Mulla's opinion on this. Mr. Mulla, he says that this whole scheme has been a disaster. He thinks that productivity has gone down because of that, and he's questioning what kind of asset building has been done in this.
I do not agree with that. This is first thing that it was name of the employment guarantee scheme.
Yes.
First thing.
Yes.
So it do some justice to the name.
Right.
It's because lakhs and lakhs of the workers, they are underfed. So because of that, they have got some jobs, some better life, and some improvement of their wage.
Yes.
That is one concrete thing. Secondly, the assets are created.
Yes.
Then this water body, then improvement of the land, and soil conservation,
yes,
foresting. This type of asset has been created, but the assessment should be done, as he said. That is second thing.
Right.
Thirdly, these people, a section of the farmers, they say increase the cost of the production and no labor. Labor, thousands and thousands of workers, agriculture workers, still they are migrating.
Yes.
There is no question of dearth of labor. That is not correct. Fourthly, this production also has been increased. That should be properly researched and qualified. That is necessary.
Yes.
But finally, I will say one thing, that this, agricultural cost, agriculture has become a matter of loss today, the whole country.
Yes.
But because 300 rupees that fertilizer, you have to purchase 1,200 rupees.
Yes.
Then the cost of water, cost of everything increased.
Yes.
Why you are blaming only labor?
Yeah.
That is another attitude, I do not know that this is correct.
Okay. Santosh, it's very interesting what Mr. Mulla was saying, that, apart from just the labor, blaming the labor is not the right thing, the higher cost of labor. But one more thing, that is one question. The second question which I want to ask you is about the migration. One of the objectives of this scheme was to stop this rural migration into urban areas. Has there been any study? Do you have any information about any of this, of how migration has been affected in any way?
There have been studies, and I think there is plenty of evidence regardless of which part of the country you talk to, whether it's in Punjab, Haryana, or even in Andhra Pradesh, that despite the slowdown in migration, there was definitely a slowdown in migration thanks to NREGA. Mm. But despite the slowdown in migration, indeed there are labor shortages occurring in parts of Andhra Pradesh, in Haryana, in Punjab. And in Punjab and Haryana, there are labor shortages in both industry as well as in agriculture, which is also sort of driving up wages in those areas. So there's no question about that. I think your real issue is the following. See, agriculture faces many problems, some of which are being addressed by NREGA itself. For instance, as was mentioned earlier, the productivity of small and marginal farms is being raised by works on their farms.
Right.
Point one. Point two. One of the serious problems with small and marginal farms, but all farms, is the water table is falling in many blocks of the country. And NREGA's works have focused on watershed management as larger watershed. So that has helped to improve watershed management. But at the same time, there are many problems of agriculture which have nothing to do with NREGA. I mean, there are low yields, not just in rain-fed agriculture, unlike what Mr. Chengal Reddy is saying. There are low yields even in other well-irrigated areas. There is a problem of no extension workers. The extension system has collapsed. There is the problem of limited research and the application of research, as the Prime Minister himself was speaking about just yesterday. So there are problems of increasing agricultural productivity which have nothing to do with NREGA, which have to be addressed separately.
That's right. But Nikhil, coming to you, if you read the report of Mr. Mehir Sain's, Dr. Mehir Sain's report, Mehir Shah's report, it's evident that raising agriculture productivity is also one of the key concerns of NREGA. Yeah. So it has been
and it is. I want to say two things.
Yeah,
firstly,
yeah.
What Mr. Reddy is raising and laying the blame on NREGA.
Right.
The problem is actually of the agricultural sector, and I cannot understand why we can't all stand together to say that problems of fertilizers, pricing, cost, how the MSP will work, procurement, all those issues do need to be looked at.
Right.
But you can't blame NREGA for those issues.
Right.
And you can't blame anyone whose wages are going up and coming just to a decent minimum level.
Right.
That cannot. Secondly, even now there are large parts of the country, and this part two of NREGA has to deal with that. Even now you don't have a truly demand-driven scheme.
Absolutely.
There are many parts where people are unable to put in their work applications and get receipts. So those parts of the country, we have to actually make NREGA work as well as it is working in some other places.
Right. Nikhil, I think, one second, I think Dr. Mesha also made this point the other day. He said so far NREGA has been more of a target-driven scheme. It needs to become a demand-driven scheme.
Absolutely. It needs to, because that is the first step and the first part of NREGA.
Right.
Third thing is where this whole issue of corruption is raised very often. Actually, NREGA has shown us how people are at the grassroots level, thousands of places, fighting corruption.
Right.
Now, there our system actually has to give them the support that they require. They are taking great guts into their hands to say this is how. And where do we not have corruption? NREGA is at least showing how it can be stopped. And it is the first scheme that is actually making social audit an integral part of it, making it something that is a statutory requirement, showing the way for the future.
Right.
So I think what we need to do is concentrate on understanding where are its areas of weakness, strengthen those areas, and realize that this is something that is not just a safety net, it has had a whole lot of spin-off effects.
Okay.
But its core area is giving people work at a decent wage, and making sure that the assets are of benefit to them.
Absolutely. Thank you, Nikhil. Thanks for joining me. Let me go to Chengal Reddy. Mr. Reddy, you don't seem to have much support here in this panel, at least, about your contentions as far as NREGA is concerned.
You are fundamentally forgetting farmers never had support all these 20 years of liberalization. That's why, if you see the difference between the service and industrial sector, 8% growth, and farming sector, 2% growth, it is basically the agriculture sector problems have never been understood by Delhi. See, agriculture is not a culture, my friend. Agriculture is something of an enterprising nature.
Yes.
Today, modern agriculture, why is that India is so much of still the suicides, you are not able to curtail suicides.
Okay, Mr. Reddy, I have one.
The whole problem is...
Mr. Reddy, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Do you think that if Narega is scrapped, agriculture sector will look up?
You must understand that dumping 50,000 crores on whimsical and fanciful attitude of the leaders of the country, whereas at the same time, you are removing subsidy to fertilizer, you are not paying a remunerative price to farmers, you are not supplying machinery, you don't give drip irrigation to farmers, you have no extension system to farmers.
Okay.
Do you think you are justified? Ask my friends whether they are justified in... When 50,000 crores we service farmers, can
okay.
this 50,000 crores be not spent for farmers' welfare?
Okay.
Ask them.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Reddy. Thanks for joining us. It was very interesting to have your views on these issues. Let me come to Santosh Santogia.
You see, I think...
The points raised by Mr. Reddy.
Yeah, Mr. Reddy's numbers are unfortunately dated. Mr. Reddy is saying agriculture is growing at 2% per annum. It was growing at 2% per annum in the country during the 10th plan period. During the 11th plan period, 2007 to 2012, the average rate of growth of agriculture has been 3.6% per annum. Yes. So the growth rate of agriculture has gone up, no question about that. Why it has gone up, it may well be on account of the productivity improvements as a result of, partly on account of investments in Narega, but
yes.
there are likely to be other reasons as well, which need to be investigated. The point is that the Manrega number two, the guidelines, the Manrega number two is precisely focused on actually improving agricultural productivity.
Absolutely.
So I'm really,
yes.
you know, vermicomposting, now it can be spent, biogas,
right.
system of rice intensification, creation of poultry shelters, goat shelters,
yes.
fisheries and rice.
A lot of new works have come and expanded.
Right.
Okay, last words to you, Mr. Mulla. So you think that this... The new guidelines which have come up is going to help further. There are good, but there are. Do you see any problem there which needs to be plugged?
No, we think that some more activities should be added.
The yes.
state government should be given some
flexibility
because you cannot decide from Delhi
okay.
what is available there. So more flexibility and that this fund release
and all needs to be improved.
There,
okay, thank
improved.
You. Okay. We have completely run short of time. So it's pretty evident that despite the strong opposition of certain sections of the people, certain sections of the farmers like Mr. Chengal Reddy, it is evident that Narega is something which has done good to this country and it can do further good if it is implemented properly, as Mr. Mulla was talking about, give more space to the state governments to decide, you know, see that these funds are released in time and all that. So thank you very much for joining. Thanks to all my guests, Mr. Nikhil Day, Mr. Chengal Reddy, Mr. Hanan Mulla, and Dr. Santosh Mehrotra. We'll come back to you with another issue on the big picture. Thank you very much.